Hi, welcome to Tech Thursday, series where we look at technical problems and challenges in various analytical tools such as Excel, Tableau, Python, or SQL. Today, we'll jump into Excel to show how to convert text to numbers, where we see numbers, but Excel insists to treat them as text. What you can see on my screen is perhaps a situation that you have encountered. So, we do have numbers, oh, so does it appear, you know, 1, 2, 3, and so on, but we do have this green triangle here informing us that something is not correct. And indeed, it isn't correct. If I highlight those numbers, I should have a sum here down in the bottom, but I only have a count. I don't have a sum, I don't have an average. Because, for example, if I do have numbers here, I do have a count, but I also have a sum and an average. So this is how we know these are not numbers, even though I am selecting a proper formatting. Now, if I go to general and maybe try to select it again to a number, that doesn't change a thing. There's also one other trick to very quickly notice that this isn't a number, meaning, for example, for every date, for Excel is a number and convert the, you can convert a number to the date. So if I'll go here, choose short date, you can see, yeah, converted that to a date, and go back to the number and so on. So what can we do? Well, there's a long way to do it and there's a short way to do it. So there's a dumb way to do it or there's a clever way to do it. The dumb way to do it is to go in each and every cell, go here, click enter, and then when you sort of change, let's say, the cell by just clicking enter, the value of the cell gets checked again and it converts to number. But that's not the best practice because I have only 8 cells here, but imagine having 1,000, right? So what can you do, and I just go back by using Control Z, what can you do is to go to data and use this fantastic function called text to columns. What it does is that if I take a column like this here, but you could just select a few cells and go text to columns, it will change the type of the value in the column by looking on each specific cell. So here, if we would do more complex thing, we would think about whether we want delimited or fixed width, but we actually want delimited. And here we can just straight out of the bat click finish. There are other, let's say, options within this functionality, but what you want to do is to just go cell by cell, which this function will do, and to convert it. So you can just click finish. And look, it went numbers. You can see here, there's an average, there's sum, so we have it. Now, if you have several columns like this, so one column, second column, I don't know, third column, let's say, ideally you would think that, okay, I'm just gonna select 3 columns, there go text to columns, but that results in an error. Excel actually can convert, as it tells you, only one column at a time. That means you would have to use a VBA code or a macro to convert multiple columns using this functionality. Oops, sorry. So what you can do is you can write such a macro, or you can check out my channel because soon I'll be sharing a video where I'll show such a solution. But meanwhile, when you have only one column, this solution, meaning using text to columns, is one of the best to get rid of this annoying green triangle that otherwise would drive you mad. Ah, and for my Polish audience who normally hear me talking Polish, yes, we're gonna do this series in English. I hope to release a video on Thursday, every Thursday if possible, and you're gonna kill 2 birds with 1 stone, meaning you're gonna learn English, which is part of being in IT, and you're gonna learn some quick solution and various analytical tools. So I hope that suits you as well. All the best. Cheers.